Dublin in the Midlands. Good evening to everyone. At this time, I would like to welcome our chaplain to the podium to please lead us on a word of prayer, as we do not proceed without inviting God's presence over our event this evening.
Father, we are grateful for this beautiful day that you've given us. We thank you for all the opportunities that you've given us as a community, and especially the opportunities that you've provided for our young people and our children. We ask that you would teach us not to take these lessons for granted. But as you have given them gifts in many areas, we thank you for the interest shown by teachers, educators, parents, and others to develop that which you have given us. And Lord, as we have gathered as a community to celebrate their talents and their abilities, we pray that you would honor what we present this evening. We bless you, we praise you, and we say thanks. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Good night, everyone. I can't hear you. Good night, everyone. How y'all feeling tonight? How you feeling tonight? Anybody out the ELiza Primary School, make some noise? Listen, that didn't come with me. The theme, which is celebrating the Turks and Caicos Island culture. You know, many times we have events and we see a lot of stuff going on, but we don't see enough of our culture. And I feel like at this time, we want to teach the young children our culture. I'll tell you something. Some years ago, I think it was last year, I was home and I was talking about the cultural songs and I was singing, "Did you see Uncle Lou?" Today, I think one is under 50, the other one is over 50. You ready, Reverend Julia? wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, before we really get into the meat of the matter, we're going to call Mrs. Nyree Williams, and she's going to come now to introduce these very important people for tonight, the judges. Put your hands together for her as she comes.
This was a song that you guys know. This is a song that was written
some many years ago. These groups have the task of making this song into a choral speech, and they can customize it however they please. So this is going to be interesting. One thing I can say though is that the ELiza Primary School children have talent. Anybody agree with that? And we cannot start this program without acting. Is it going to be Tigers tonight? What about the world? Anybody care to cheer for Bowen? Anybody love the Lions? Now,
Three, four, five, and one.
straw hats, director in a nice cut bright yellow. Listen, I want to be behaving. You know how it is. I'd step on the side, I'm watching everybody. And you can tell the parents as they are. The children come to really to. You can look and see who's parents and who's children for the yellow house. But when I watch the teacher come out with that jacket, and I look down at the expression on my good friend Pete's face. And I noticed she was wearing a blue shirt, so I said, she couldn't be cheering for the yellow house. But she tapped the pastor on her side, she said, she was a good yellow church, right? I read her lips, and if that ain't what she said, well, I'm from T.I., that's what I hear. is in Lulaboo. The guy in here just belongs to me. These children are doing well. Anybody agree? Yes. Parents from the Waltz House, do you agree? Yes. I can tell you, there is talent at the ELiza Center. Right? I thought he was coming to another dance.
Time to make some noise as we invite the Lions!
Wow. Halfway through. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to talk a bit because they're supposed to be giving me the point bell. We are halfway through. You have just seen the kindergarten to break one section. And I know that now you guys are on the edge of your seats. These children have really came to compete. I can remember the last time they had this thing. They had one of my good friends, Principal Thelwell. He was a teacher back then. Now in the House of Assembly. And a pastor. He's covered. I call him names. Because I ain't about to call the name. But he's one of the governor's appointed members. And his last name is Butterfield. Call him nobody name up in here. That young man had on Michael Jackson gloves. I surprised I see the white gloves. You wasn't here. When is it? All his arm and shoulder was hugging the next day. Called me, asked me if I had anything to put on shoulder. Walked the shoulder out of place direct and quiet. I asked him if he's fighting. That's how passionate he was. I can tell you, children, y'all enjoy these days where you're not gonna see 4 and 5 horses without getting tired. Nowadays, me and Nixon, Brother Morris and them, after every boss, we need a water break. You know how it is, Ryan. And if we can dance, we can't dance and sing. And if we can sing, we can't sing and dance. You gotta choose one. Once it's been verified with the DPP office, then it can be released to the public. So Mistress Terry Brooks is going through the file, verifying if all scores are accurate and correct. Ryan, it seems like you're cheering for the green team. Oh, how people switch. Last time you were for another team. All of a sudden for the green team. But I mean, whose team you cheering for? For part one of the competition, kindergarten to grade one, Carl speaking and choir. In fourth place, with 165 points, we have the Wolves House. Put your hands together for them. In third place, with 217 points, make some noise for the Tiger's House. Got two left, y'all. Got two left. In second place, with 257 points, we have the Bowen House. And in first place, with 274 points, we have the So ladies and gentlemen, can you have it? Those are the scores for part one. We are now headed to competition two. This competition ranges from grade two to grade by opting to make some noise for the Tigers' house. That's grade 2-6. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Woman's House. I don't know about you, but I feel that extra energy now. They're ready for the second half. Which house was it that my good honorable pastor was a part of? Oh, he was a part of the green. I figured so when I saw the gloves. And listen, he was so excited. You know when you watch somebody do something, you show your little thing. I started having time now, I heard pressure go up. Ladies and gentlemen, I got something to tell you all, but I can wait till after this. Because the children are coming, and I have a good little piece of business to share with you all here tonight. Don't worry, hold on. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we invite now the Red House. Give it up for the boys!
Wrote the poem, Mr. Ripsaw, who she was talking about? Well,
He does the honor of masking. Oh, good to see you, Mr. Kennedy. I didn't even know it was you. I'm looking like a blue shadow on the wall. And I said, that could not be you. And I looked good. I said, it looked like you. You know, while I was walking to the back just now to get some warm, I saw my good cousin Jennifer Forbes. And she said, how you doing, Carlos? I said, how you doing? I gave her a nice hug and a good kiss on my cheek. And she said, well, Carlos, I'm wearing blue tonight. And my legs are strong. Now, people may not understand what went down, but I saw her on December 15th. I don't know which day that is, but I saw her on December 15th. She wasn't wearing blue. She's wearing another color. I don't remember the color name. But I can tell you her legs were so weak. Two people had to like squat in the vehicle to carry her home. So I got to see my cousin strong again. She said, and my legs strong. So I like to tell you, you might swear. You may, people don't care. People say, you may swear. I can tell you, children have made an appearance to some serious, serious things. I wish we could have this all year round so that we could keep our, you know what I talk about, right? Lovely point. Very much so. And I feel like we should put our hands together and give Miss Angela Freites a hand for such awesome point that those houses just recited. But coming up shortly, we have the creative dance competition. This will not be done by the students, but it will be done shoes. So I can't wait to see this. Brother Pop got his robe from that American church. Is he ready? I can tell you this is going to be something tonight. But ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we go into the choir section. And the theme for the choir section is folk melody. Folk melody. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to put your hands together as we invite, coming first, the Tigers House. Put your hands together for the Tigers.
Thank you.
honorable judges tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, moving right along, we're going to invite the Red House. Please put your hands together for the charging
Ladies and gentlemen, do you agree that this competition is heating up? I say this thing too close to call. I don't know. But we will know after this. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I want you to now put your hands together as we invite none other than the Roaring Lions! you, Honorable. Thank you. And I believe the principal has to pull them in and tell them to wind up. Because I see two of them was ready to kick off. And when they looked down at the Juliet, they said, boy, don't mess with that. She gave them that eye. I call it the 80s eye. You know, it's different now with some of the children than it was in the 80s. The 80s, we didn't have to get beat too much. You got to give them that eye. Now listen. Audience, let me just brief you. I was told a few minutes ago that these parents tonight are coming with some stuff you have never seen before. I walked in the back there just now, and I happened to walk.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.